easy will I do? Of course, we want it to appear easy. And perhaps sometimes it is. When my characters introduce themselves and show me what they want to do. Even then, I want the sound of my words to be delicious, yet the meaning nourishing. There can't be a question of style or substance. One without the other is, at best, pretentious, at worst, offensive. I wonder, is all creation the same? Does the composer choose his notes, or do the notes choose the composer? Inspiration. It's in the word. It's being breathed into me like a telephone line to God. But this line is not always clear. A little static. Or... oh, help me. Should the connection drop and am I playing God myself? Consequential, and this can't be for me to judge. I mean, creating and assessing are entirely different processes, and by attempting one, I will automatically be useless at the other. Create, and I do not know if it's arrogance that drives me. If I don't create, will the pressure mount until my mind explodes? What is the greater sin? My presumptuousness in creating or sloth? Enjoyment as such ever takes place or by dissection or analysis on the other hand, but this will never be for me. No. The immortality I seek is driven by vanity and will do me no good. For I am doomed to live in the prelude.
Thank you.
ego dictates that I withdraw from the stream of life in order to serve mankind. To provide moments of interest and beauty to my fellows. Throughout this process, exactly not my fellows. I conjure up worlds. Yet I'm doomed to shrink away from the real world. Its quirks and tangible delights. This is a creation, as set out by the first law of thermodynamics. Nothing comes out of nothing. And by creating, I am slowly, imperceptibly transferring my divine spark to my own creation. My soul is dying, as my creation comes to life. This brings me upon a deep, dark sadness, melancholy. longer obey me. False friends who I forge with my own laborious agonies are lurking in the corners. When I turn my head to face them, they pretend to behave. They mockingly assume poses they think will appease me. But the next second they've changed. Pretending to be someone else. And subtly disguise not only their appearances, but their reasons for being. They tell me all is fine, that they only have done as I have taught them. They say I should be proud forging such fine, upstanding citizens of my mind, and I almost believe them. Am I not their benefactor? Tyranny, they whisper, low enough so I cannot hear them. Pretending to behave. Mocking me again by taking on two-dimensional form. When I avert my eyes, the shadows are dancing.
I want to destroy my own creation. By absorbing it, I can make myself whole again. In all the ancient texts, one world dies, so another can rise from the ashes. I am not ready to be ashes. And why should I not tyrannize my own creation? Is it not my property? Yet my God-given right? Let my creation become ashes, so I myself can rise like a phoenix. Free, joyous, strong, I soar without a second's regret for my own creation. These are my rages. Well earned. Terrible. Yet just.
Thank you.